All right, so today I'm trying to wire up my three-way smart switch. First thing I did was open my existing three-way switch to study the wiring. So what you're gonna find here is the back of a regular switch. This is a toggle switch. So the two blacks on the bottom there, they're on the same circuit, and they are actually, one of them is either the power coming in or the, you know, the power going out to the fixture, and then the other switch would have a traveler going over to it, and then another wire. It's the exact same wire setup with the two blacks on the bottom and the one red up top to the load on both switches. So what I have to do is kind of troubleshoot and determine which wire is the power coming from the building and which wire is the traveler. So what I want to do is I'm going to pop out the wire from the switch. So right now they're just using the regular push-in. So if you watch any of my other videos, you just wiggle them back and forth to get them out of the switch. So I wiggled out the red and one of the blacks for now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually just twist them together right now to see to make a contact, and then I'm going to go on the other side and check if there's continuity using my multimeter. So I'm on the other side now. I left the red in there. I just made the contact with it. And then the first wire I touched, I think this one has continuity. So I know that those two wires are the ones that are traveling across. So I'm gonna end up only using one of these wires, and the other one I'm just gonna end up capping out. So. And so this means this is a load to the building. All right, so back to the box. So one of the things, as I was pulling it all apart after I tested all the wires and then figuring out which one was the building line, what I did was I took the building line out, and then I kind of just looked at my box right now, and I know it's the line because it goes into that bundle of other black wires in there in this dual gang switch, and it's actually a quad gang because it shares the box down there. So I know that is the line that's coming into this switch since I'm on the main side and not the traveler side. Then the red right now, I'm assuming is a traveler to the other side, and also the black travels to the other side. So one of the things I think, somewhere it goes up to the light. I gotta kind of study a three-way switch to figure that out right now, so I'll report back once I do some troubleshooting. All right, so I'm back on the second traveler side of the switch. So I studied the wiring, so it looks like I figured it out. So it looks like in my particular box, I see that I've got the traveler, which has the red, black, and white, and that goes to the other box on the other side. And that's what I tested continuity earlier on. And then over here, I also have this other wire, which is the white and black, neutral and hot, and it goes up. So I'm guessing this is going up to my lights right there. So what I'm gonna have to do, since this is the travel shot, I'm actually gonna wire the two blacks together. That way I make this connection back to the main switch over there to complete that circuit. And then from there, I wire the two blacks line and load onto my smart switch. Then I use the red coming off of here as the traveler for my smart switch. All right, so we're back and I made all my wiring connections. So if you look closely, you'll see what I did. If you watched any of my other smart smart switch install videos, yeah, I told you about the requirement for the neutral. Most houses built before 2012 or 2010 did not have this in the box, and you may have to pull your own neutral wire, which is the white wire, back to the, you know, to the light or wherever it comes from. But luckily my house is newer, so I've got it in there anyway. So I had to run that white jumper into this bundle in the box of neutrals, because usually they're in the box but they don't connect to anything. And then this jumper comes with the switch. Then down here you'll notice this black wire nut with a bundle of wires. That's the line coming from the building. So I've got that into the line of the switch. And then back here was that, the traveler wire back over the other side, which I'm gonna jumper over there with the wire nut. And then I've got the earth ground, which is the bare copper wire to the top of the light. And you'll notice I use the push in connectors on all these, because for this switch you push it in and then you tighten the nuts on the either side to get that to fit right. And if you watch my other video, you also have the option of making the little U-loop, putting it around this screw here and then screwing it down. You'll also notice I haven't made the red traveler connection yet, which is still hanging right there. It goes behind this no 120 volt traveler slot, so they put that warning there to make sure you don't, you make sure that that wire is just connected to the other side on the remote switch for the Z-Wave. Alright, so I'm back on this other side. So I was talking about making that connection to jumper the load leg onto the other side. So I'm over here, I twisted it together with some pliers to make sure I get good connection. I'm gonna put an orange wire nut on it and then tuck this back into the box. So over here I've made the connections on my remote switch. So if you saw my unboxing video of these switches, so this side, this switch is actually a remote switch. It'll work with Z-Wave, Zigbee, Wi-Fi, whatever it is. It doesn't really have any radios in it. All it's doing is switching the other switch that has the radio in it. So I plugged in the traveler wire, which is the red wire that I determined over here. This switch still needs a neutral, so I use the jumper that came with the switch, and then I plugged it to the neutral on the building side that's in the box on the newer homes. So I'm gonna test this after this. So I've got the breaker on. You got a good sign of a light here. So switch is on, switch is off on this side. So I'm gonna check the traveler side. All right, I'm over here on the traveler side. So right now, there's no lights on this thing. I guess it doesn't have an indicator light or anything. It's just a remote switch. So I'm gonna off, on, off, on. So it works. All the wiring is good. I gotta tuck everything back in the box and put it back together. So that's how you wire up a three-way smart switch using GE. This is probably the same for all smart switches.